Hey guys, YouTube, everybody watching, this is BA Dad and Sons. I'm Dad.
I'm Son.
Yeah. We're going to do a review today, like I promised. We're doing a 1/18 scale O-Speed HS Storm. Let's do a spin around the truck here. The thing's got some good lines, I must say. What do you think, Dayton?
I think it looks pretty slick. It
looks pretty awesome. It's really lightweight. Comes with a 2.4 gigahertz controller with just a steering trim. I think it takes 3 AA batteries. I already got them in there. I just can't remember how many I put, but the truck comes with some batteries. Actually, look at this. I got a screwdriver. Yeah, how about that? My assistant. He's gonna check, make sure that we have 3 AA batteries. A screwdriver. Yes, 3 AA batteries in that. Get his Vanna White hands in there. Oh yeah, look at that. We got a 1200 milliamp hour, 7.4 volt lithium ion battery. That should make for some good runtime, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so too. So, we're gonna get this plugged in for you. But before we do, we'll just go over some of the features of this truck. Everything in this truck looks like it has a cover over it, which still makes it, it's still upgradable, but it's just going to be a little bit harder to upgrade if you want to put things on there, because you got to take all the covers off. The chassis seems to be really stout. The shocks are plastic friction shocks. I don't know if you can see them there. But the truck is light, so I don't think it's going to be an issue with suspension. All the control arms, the CV shafts, everything is plastic. Just a lot like the HBX that we just reviewed last week. It's got some really... got some really pliable bumpers. The plastic is really flexible. The servo looks like it's a pretty decent servo. I did notice that the wheels have ball bearings all the way around. Instead of screws, the HBX had screws. This has wheel nuts. But anyway, oh, and it also has this on and off switch on the side here, which kind of makes it nice when you get your canopy on.
Take the cover off.
What's that?
You don't have to take the body off.
Yeah, you don't have to, like he said, you don't have to take the body off. It's just exposed right there. It's kind of
35
nice.
Kilometers per hour, which is 21 miles an hour, which I still doubt it does 21, but I bet you it does 20 or maybe 18.
These are really great for young kids, beginners, and even they're fun for hobbyists as well. So let's get this thing on the ground and start pounding it. All right, guys, we got the truck ready to go. Take it for a little bash, but a couple things I did wanna mention that I didn't mention in just previously. It's got a 380 motor in this. It's a brushed motor. So it should be a pretty awesome little motor for this little, it's light, very light truck. These tires, I didn't really show them to you. They're really wide. The rubber seems to be like a medium compound. Not super grippy, but seems like it'll be grippy enough. Looks like there's about 3/4 of an inch to an inch of ground clearance underneath. So it should be able to go through the grass pretty well, but we'll see. Also, it does come with a USB port charger. For your battery, it's a 2S. See, I don't know if you can see that. It's a 2S plug. Just like the HBX, you get two lights that come on
red and green. While it's charging, the green is flashing. When it's done, the green is solid with the red. And yeah, that's the charger.
Nice. Is it stuck? How's the range? Does it seem like it has good range, Dayton?
Let's see.
It's already better than the high-boxing, the HVX ratchet. That didn't have very good range. That was my only issue with that. This one right here has
really, really good range.
And it's pretty quiet, really.
Oh. No scratches?
Oh, that's all right. We're gonna get scratches. That's why these things are inexpensive. I mean, this is, like I said, you can buy oil-filled shocks for this. Whoa. You can get a brushed motor. You can do all the things you do with hobby grade vehicles for this. And that's what's cool about these. You spend little money and you can make them monsters on the pavement or on the dirt. Nice. A good little drifter, huh?
Yeah.
We're gonna try to put more videos out for you guys. If you like the content that you're seeing, slam that subscribe button. Like it if you like it. Don't if you don't. But we love this hobby. We've been doing it for a while. We just getting going on YouTube videos here. We want you guys to be able to see what this hobby's about. And it's a family hobby. It's a personal hobby. It's something to do when you're outside. It gets you outside. And you don't have to spend a lot of money, and that's why I'm making these videos. I mean, we will have some higher end cars and trucks on this channel. We're gonna try to keep it affordable if we can. Oh, where'd it go? There it is. Yep. Out of sight. Now it's back in sight. Yeah, this goes through the grass really good, Dayton.
Yeah, it goes through really easily.
Yeah, it does. Oh, look, look. The grass must be wet because you're like spraying some water behind you. Rooster tails. I love it. I will leave the link of where I got this, like I said, at banggood.com. I will leave it in the description. And I believe you can also find it on Amazon, and I will leave a link to that. But for a under 50 bucks, you can't go wrong. Look at the range on that thing. It has really, really good range for a little truck like this. I mean, he's almost 100 yards out. I can't believe you. I can't even see it. That about it? Oh no, he's got range. Yeah, he's trying to see if he can get it back. You might have to take a couple steps forward. There you go, bring it back in. All right, guys, like I said, bang on that bell on the subscribe button. We'd like to see you watching our videos. Dayton. I think he had a fun time playing with it as well as me.
Really
like
fun.
I said, it's a, yeah, it is fun. It, little car like this is make a little kid happy, and it'll make an adult happy. All right, guys, we'll see you later.